Şimdiden. Testing. Come on, and it's such a beautiful day. Good morning, Trinity.
Good morning.
I don't know about you, but I am so happy and thankful to be in the house of the Lord. I don't know how your week went, but I'm here with joy in my heart to praise and worship God. Yes. I'm here to give all honor and glory
Amen.
To God.
Yes.
Now, my week didn't go that good. In fact, it was kind of tough. I lost a daughter who belongs to another mother. Total shock and disbelief. And then the phone started ringing. And when I looked, I knew why the people were calling. And it was like, God, I haven't got my heart wrapped around this myself. How can I help them? And this is what God laid on my heart. Zip it, kick yourself to the curb, and trust me.
Amen.
Zip it, kick yourself to the curb, and trust me. I did that. And today I am grateful, grateful, grateful. Because today I'm sharing with you what's flowing from my heart. Issues of my heart. Keeping it real.
Yes, yes.
Because even though the week was hard, even though my heart is breaking, and those of so many others broken, just like that, God can and will
yes.
get you through it.
Yes, he will.
He will give you words. Amen. I'm going to share with you a quote that God just dropped in my lap this morning. And this is what it says. Wisdom is nothing but healed pain. Once again, wisdom is nothing but healed pain. I've had my share of heartache and pain, but it was not for, it wasn't lost. There was a reason and a purpose from God that someday, no matter what you're going through right now,
yeah.
what pain, what heartache, what struggle,
yeah.
God will bring it back as a blessing
yeah.
because you will be able to bless somebody else
yeah.
through your pain. So I don't know about you, if that doesn't make you happy to be worshiping the God that we worship, I need you to stand on your feet because I'm standing here brokenhearted, but I'm smiling and I'm praising God in the midst of it because God is good.
And if we could please stand and sing, Lord, I lift your name on high. Love, I, Lord, I love to sing your praises.
Yeah.
Amen.
Save us. I'm so glad you came to save us.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
We lift your name on high. You're a mighty God. You're an awesome God. And now we will jointly read our scripture reading of the day, coming from Psalms 25, verses 1 through 5. Let's read the word of God. In you, Lord my God, I put my trust. I trust in you. Do not let me be put to shame. Nor let my enemies triumph over me. No one hath hopes in you will ever be put to shame, but shame will come on those who are treacherous without cause. Show me your ways, Lord. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are my God and Savior. And my hope is in you all day long.
Amen.
My God and my Savior.
Yes.
And I hope in you all day long. I don't know what helps you have in your heart today, but this is the time we come to the altar. Some of you battered and abused, brokenhearted, sick at heart, finances, family matters, no matter what, bring it to the altar and know that you have the hope in that cross of Christ Jesus.
What a great God we serve today. You know, Rosemary was talking about how she was going through this week. And it's been a trying week for all of us, I think. I know I've been going through this week. You know, I've been in emergency twice this week with my mom. But I know God is able to do just what he said he would do. And I got a text from two friends this week, talking about their trials and the things that they were going through and asking for prayer. And even while I'm down in the valley, I'm still going to put up a prayer for my friends, because I know God could use me even when I need someone to pray for me. But I know that God said that he would never leave us nor forsake us, even when we're at our wits' end and don't know what to do. Because I'm not sure if you guys even know, if you had to experience what I'm going through. And for those that parents have been sick, it's not easy to sit there and watch your loved one go through whatever they're going through, and you can't do anything but call on the name of Jesus. And that's the best thing that you could do, because God will be done in this world. Amen. Because as we all know, this is not our home. We're just strangers passing through and praying that we could touch somebody's life while we're still here. So I'm going to ask that you just remember those that are in need today, and especially for my mom, I'm going to selfishly ask that you lift up a prayer for her today. She's going to be coming through the door shortly, and I thank God that she's still here, even through whatever she's going through. Amen. Because the doctors are talking about dialysis and all of those things, but I know but God, because it doesn't matter what the doctor said, we know what God says. And I also want you to lift her up because her sister just got diagnosed with kidney cancer. So my Aunt Lena is going to be going through surgery on the 1st. So we're dealing with a lot of stuff, but you know what? We still see Jesus in the midst of it all. Amen. And even when I'm down, if you see a tear coming from my eye, just know that I still trust God. It's just my human emotions that will take over. But I know what I know what I know. And I thank God for the blessing. And Alicia, it's so good to see you here this morning. We thank God for you and we're praying for you. Let us lift up to the Lord today. Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for this day, Lord God. We thank you for such a time as this, Lord God, where we can come to the altar, Lord God, just to lay down our burdens, Lord God. And those that have things on their mind, Lord God, and they don't know what else to do, Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, that we could come to this place, Lord God. Lord God, where you will hear our prayers, Lord God. And Lord God, if it's your will, Lord God, that you will give us desires of our hearts, Lord God. Dear God, we thank you, Lord God, for those that are here, Lord God, and for those that are on the way, Lord God. We pray for traveling mercy for those people, Lord God, that are on their way, Lord God. And Lord God, for those that are sick today and are shut in, Lord God, we ask that you dispatch one of your angels from heaven, Lord God, that they will go and sit on their rooftops, Lord God, that they will feel the presence of your Holy Spirit in their house, Lord God. And Lord God, whatever they're going through, Lord God, that they will call on the name of Jesus, Lord God, because you say by your stripes we are healed, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, for the power of the Holy Spirit that dwells right here at Trinity, Lord God. We can feel your presence in this place, Lord God. Lord God, you say that we have but faith the size of a mustard seed, that, Lord God, that you would grant us those things, Lord God. Dear God, we trust in you today, Lord God, for everything, Lord God, the little things as well as the big things, Lord God. And, Lord God, for those, Lord God, that are depressed today, Lord God. Lord God, we ask that you would just encourage their hearts today, Lord God. Put a smile on their face, Lord God. And for those, Lord God, that have lost loved ones, Lord God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you will wrap your loving arms around them right now, Lord God. Let them know, Lord God, that they're not alone, Lord God, that you love them and you know them and you're concerned about them, Lord God. And Lord God, that their loved one, Lord God, may be absent from here, Lord God, but that their presence with you, Lord God, sleeping in your bosom, Lord God. For we know, Lord God, that we will see them again, Lord God, in the morning, Lord God. Lord God, we just have to live right and do right, Lord God. And Lord God, that you will welcome us into your kingdom, Lord God. And Lord God, we don't care what the doctors say, Lord God. We know it's what you say, Lord, and that your will be done in everything in our lives, Lord God. So we're trusting and believing you today, Lord God, for everything, Lord God. And Lord God, we want to lift up our children today, Lord God, as they get ready to go back to school, Lord God. Continue to be with them, Lord God. And Lord, that no weapon forms against them shall prosper, dear God. Lord God, no matter what they've run into on the college campus, Lord God, in the high schools, Lord God, wherever they may find themselves, Lord God, let them remember that they have a word, Lord God, in their back pocket that they can pull out, Lord God. And it's called Jesus. And that they not be afraid of the gospel of God. That they will spread the good news to someone that needs it, Lord God. And Lord God, if they have to stand by themselves, Lord God, let them stand, Lord God. Stand in truth, Lord God. Lord God, let them stand on your word, Lord. Lord God, I thank you right now, Lord God, for our pastor, Lord God, this man of God that you have blessed here at Trinity, Lord God. Continue, Lord God, to bless him, Lord God, in everything that he does. Continue to give him a word, Lord God, from you, Lord God, as you do every Sunday, that he spread the good news of Jesus to your people, Lord God, just like you gave it to him, Lord. And Lord God, we pray for everyone in the sanctuary today, Lord God, those that are here and those that are on the way. Let us open our ears, Lord God, and not only be hearers, but be doers of the word, Lord God. Let us go out into this dying world that we may go and spread the good news, Lord God, to someone that do not know you, and a part of your sins and of their sins, Lord God. And Lord God, that someone today may come running to the altar today and say, what must I do to be saved, Lord? Lord God, we thank you for this time of prayer, Lord God. We thank you for this opportunity. And Lord God, we never want to leave or close out anything but saying, I love you and I thank you for everything you've done, Lord God. Even though I may not have what I want, Lord God, I surely have what I need. And it's because of you. And I thank you and I lift you up right now and praise your holy name. And in Jesus' name, the church said amen and amen.
To share something with you real quick. Last weekend, Bonnie and I got to go to the Holocaust Museum, and that was such an experience for both of us. And one thing that resonated in my mind was that when they had to give the passport to the Jews, when they were trying to get into other countries, the middle initial for the males was Israel. The middle initial for the females was Sarah. That identity alone in Christ, even then, in the times of darkness, God still covered his people. When Satan means things for bad, God means it for good so that others may live. And so I thank God for that experience. And so when we say grateful, yes, grateful, flowing from my heart are the issues of my heart,
yes,
is gratefulness. Can we sing that verse one more time? Just one more time. And let's just stay there and worship with God, being grateful for what he has done.
All the things that you have done.
Lord, I'm grateful.
Yes, I'm grateful for the victories we won.
Praise you, Lord. grateful, Lord.
Is gratefulness.
In the midnight hour, we're grateful,
yes.
We're grateful. Is gratefulness. Let's give God the praise. Let's give him the praise. Woo! God is good all the time, and he is worthy to be praised. God is good
all the time.
Wait. God is good
all the time.
And he is worthy. Aren't you glad? So glad. Amen. We bring up our hymn for the morning. Blessed quietness.
Thank you. As we all return back to our seats, always excited to see our family and friends. Amen. Amen. Have several announcements today. So we all want to perk up our ears and get ready. Some of it's new for me too, so I'm excited to read what everyone has to share with us. So today, excuse me, our announcements for Second Sunday. Today, Children's Church, immediately after, I believe the children, excuse me, will be ministering to us today. So immediately after that, we're going to ask that the children, 2 to 3 years old and older, will go downstairs for Sunday school. Also on Second Sunday, we have our new members orientation. If you have any questions, please see Carrie Smith or Bonnie. Also, we have our encouragement team meeting. That's also on Second Sunday, again, immediately after our services. Please feel free to come downstairs and join us. It's just a time of fellowship. If you have any prayer requests for yourself, family, or friends, please come down and join us. It's just a time that we just like to just share, and you have something you need to get off your chest, and you just need a word, a pat on the back, and just a big hug. Just come down and join us with the encouragement team. Amen. Our Compassion Center is open also today after service from 1 to 2 p.m. And I'm going to go into a few other announcements, and then I'm going to get Rosemary to come up. We have an announcement from our Women's Single Ministry. They are sponsoring our Jamaican Medical Ministry by collecting over-the-counter medications, new or gently used white flat sheets, both queen, king, or full. They can be used, these are going to be used to be partitions for the clinic. And they also can use some snack size Ziploc baggies. And those will be used for dispersing medications. All you have to do is go into the narthex. There's a blue bin, and you could put your items there. But please remember, donations must be unopened and not expired. And they will be collecting those through mid-August. If you would like to write a check instead, please write that check. And in the memo section, please say Jamaican Mission. And that way we'll make sure that's allocated to the appropriate area. They also gave us a little bit more information as far as types of pharmaceutical items. I won't read them all, but some of the main things are adult vitamins, Tylenol, fish oil, iron, a lot of the vitamins that we all take on a daily basis. So this is some of the things that they need. And again, please bring some snack-sized Ziploc bags. Right now, I'm gonna ask Rosemary to come up and speak regarding the women's ministry.
Good morning, ladies. I am overjoyed. Over the next three to four months, I'm going to be leading as we continue on in our study, experiencing God. So it's next Saturday, okay? Got it? And I've got the date right. I checked. It's next Saturday at 10 o'clock, and we're going to meet out here in the narthex. And I also want to extend a welcome and invite women who are new to the congregation and ask you to join us. I know some hearts want to come, and if you can't make it but you want to participate, see me after church, and I'll do the best I can to send you the information so you could join along at home. And I also give you my number, so after you go through the study, I'll sit and talk with you and go through it with you. So, you know, I'm very excited. I love to teach the Word of God. And this lesson isn't exactly a teaching thing. We're all going through experiencing God. I'm just leading and guiding this time around. But you'll enjoy it. It's been remarkable. And after and the topic this week is crisis in faith. Okay? Crisis in faith. And in our workbook thing we have, it's on page 133. And let me tell you, after my week this week, God's laid the lesson out for me. and I consider it a blessing. And be blessed, and I hope to see you all there.
Thanks, Rosemary, and I can speak from experience. We have a wonderful time. And just to add to that, if you don't have the book and you don't know where we are, still come out. You're going to have a good time. Amen. We share our book, and we continue to encourage each other in that area. Okay. If you would like to receive a copy of our worship service, to my right, just go to the media, and they will assist you in getting a copy of that. A reminder to tune into YWLL 1160 AM at 7 PM every Sunday evening for life lessons, and on Mondays TLN at 1 PM with our own Bishop Love. Amen. Right now, we would like to welcome any first-time visitors. If you're visiting us for the first time, we're going to ask if you would stand so we can give you a warm welcome. Any visitors today? We're happy to have you here at the Lord's house. If you remain standing for just a second, our pastor is the Bishop, Dr. Michael J. Love. Trinity is a teaching ministry of God's holy word. We touch, share, love, and care, and thank God for this opportunity to praise and worship him. If you're looking for a church home, when Bishop Love opens the door of the church, feel free to give your hearts to Christ and your hands in fellowship to Trinity. Welcome for joining us today. Thank you. You're seated. Just a reminder that Stacy Evans will be doing the announcements next week. And if you need to provide us with an announcement, we have an email address, which is tbccianouncements@gmail.com. We check that throughout the week, and if you can get that to us by Saturday by noon. But if you have it on a piece of paper, feel free to reach out to one of us on Sunday morning. Amen. Amen. And my thought for the week, as we've heard Deacon Don and Rosemary talk about, it's been a trying week for a lot of people. Amen. But you know what? What God always reminds me is to wait, to pray, and to encourage one another. And we've been doing that all year, all week. But just to share a little bit of testimony this week, while we were waiting and praying, because he says to pray without ceasing. And that just resonated with me all week. And some people are waiting to hear from maybe a job opportunity. Some maybe be hearing if they got in school, if they passed certain exams. But a lot of people are waiting to hear some medical reports this week. But during that time, we just wanted to encourage them that they were not alone and that we were praying for them. And that we were praying with them. And we've had three reports just this week, benign. Amen. And the mother of one of those says that's one of the most beautiful words she ever heard, because her child did not have cancer. So I just want you to continue to remind you that it's the little things that we could do. And again, that's to wait, to pray with one another, and continue to encourage each other. So that's my word for you today, this week. It's just to stay with each other and to pray with each other, and just know that you're not alone. Amen. Amen. Okay, just one second. I'm so used to having good news. But right now, I'm just going to turn it over to Bishop, I believe. Okay. I believe. Bishop, you're going to come up. Oh, is Deanna, I'm sorry. Does she? I don't think she has any good news. Oh, does she? Do you have good news today? Oh, we're going to do, okay, you're going to have me do happy birthdays. Help me for the announcements. Okay, do we have anyone that has birthdays during the month of August? I got it. If you want to stand up. Oh, happy birthday. birthday, everybody. And thanks, Deanna, for reminding me. Okay, now I just wish that everyone has a blessed week and just continue to love one each other and pray for one another. Amen.
You scared me when you looked over there. I'm trying to find enough. You don't want me croaking out any happy birthday songs. Yeah, Greg, I got real nervous over there. It's good to be in the Lord's house on this beautiful Sunday morning. I want to welcome our congregation joining us via the internet as we live broadcast. We're praying that you'll be blessed by something that's been said. And you pray that wherever you are in the country or the world, you may be finding a home church that will bless you. And can serve you and help you to grow in your faith. But welcome to be with us on this beautiful day. I didn't get a chance last Sunday. I wanted to get a thank you in, and it just dawned on me after service was over that I didn't get a chance. Miss Betty Like, look at she looking at me, and the Compassion Center team had an opportunity on a week ago Friday, was that right? A week ago Friday, to actually do an outreach to the Foxview community and their back-to-school outreach, and they were able to take a large amount of clothing down there and be able to bless the young folk as they were heading back to school. And it was a good full day, and they said they just had a great time. So I just want to say on behalf of the family, I just want to say thank you for your outreach. That's taking the ministry beyond the walls back there. And if we can be a blessing, Compassion Center is open after service for an hour immediately after service. So anyone who can be blessed by it or have a need, or you know someone that can be blessed by it or have a need, the clothing is very, very nice, and it's a free gift from us to you. So we thank God for that. You know, a lot of great things on the calendar, and I know the young folk are getting ready to come and bless us here. So as Sister Paula, Reverend Paula starts heading this way, let me just ask you, has the Lord blessed you this week? Has he done something for you? I know there have been some tough things going on, but the Lord is good, even in the midst of whatever we're dealing with. He's good all the time. Thank you, man.
Morning, church family. You know, it seems like the theme this morning is a week of going through. We all have had a week. I've had a week of Mondays. Anybody know how that feels? But I'm reminded of what Paul tells us. He says, whatever situation you find yourself in, be ye content. So I say to you, why are you being content? Let's be a little grateful, because it could have been worse. Amen? Gratefulness. Ooh. Like I said, I've had a week of Mondays, but there was a bright spot in this week. Some of you may not know it. My sister-in-law has been diagnosed with ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. She got a call this week. There's a new trial medicine out that can prolong the disease. She's been placed on the list. So I'm claiming right now, in Jesus' name, they're waiting on a decision, but God has the final say so. So I'm claiming for her right now that she makes it, that she's got it. And if you would join me in your prayers and just pray for her, that it goes through. Her name is Regina. I would be so grateful. You have been a wonderful church family. And on behalf of the Roof Ministry, the Singles Ministry, we want to say we are so grateful for what you've done for the Jamaican Medical Mission. We have emptied the container twice. And for what Sister Susan told me just now, it looks like it's going to get emptied again today. God is so good. He always provides everything that we need. Amen, Sister Susan. And I know we said the middle of August, but I'm going to beg. Can we extend that till when? The end of August? Till the end of August. Word says you have not because you ask not. Ushers, please come forward. The word of God says in 2 Corinthians, while we're talking about gratefulness, he reminds us that we ought to be grateful for the gifts, for God's gifts giving through his people. It says, 2 Corinthians 9:15, thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. His indescribable gift. The gift he gave of his son. I have no words. Can you even imagine? Not just that he gave his son, but he gave his son so that he may die, so that we may have life. But not just life, but life what? More abundantly. What a gift. What a gift. Thank you, Lord. When we have the opportunity to give to others, we experience the joy of knowing that God will be praised because of it. So it's giving time, church. Let's give God the praise, amen? Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for the gift that you gave, that indescribable gift that man could not give. But you, in your infinite wisdom, knew that no longer could the doves do it, could the lamb do it, but you send the Lamb of God, the one and only, your begotten Son. Father, we thank you. And Lord, we do not take it minorly. We do not take it incautiously. Father, we're just thankful. We just have no words. We are so grateful for what you did. Father, we're grateful for every morning that you wake us up to let us see another day. Sometimes it's a trying day, but Father, we are grateful that you take us through it. Because see, you don't have to. And at the end of the day, when we lay down our heads, we ought to say, thank you, Lord. It was trying, but you brought me through, and I thank you. And when I get up the next morning, mind me to say, today's another day that I can be grateful for the gift that you've given me. So, Father, as we come right now, being grateful for this gift you have given us so that we may give back, I ask that you bless your people. Touch in a mighty way. Father, as they give, your word says you will give back 100-fold. We're holding you to your word. And we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And in this, we are grateful. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
I want to first give an honor to God. To God be the glory. It's our Youth Sunday, and man, this set of youth have worked very hard. We had two rehearsals, and I've taught dance for over 30 years, and I love working with kids who don't give up and who are just determined, and that's our message this Sunday, is that they did not give up. You know, yesterday I was kind of hard on them, and you know, it's just, I told them, it's just because I love them and I want the best from them, and we have to serve God in excellence. So they're going to do a little praise dance for you and just worship with us.
Give me an old school beat. This is what we gonna do with it.
the church say amen. Pray with me today as I ask the Lord to keep this voice just long enough for me to get through the message, if it's all right. Turn with me, if you will, to Luke chapter 7. We want to spend a few minutes together around a very familiar passage of Scripture from the 11th verse. It closes out on the 17th verse. Let's take a fresh set of eyes to that episode in the life and times of Jesus. And I jotted down, I think, our key verse for the day was verse number 15. Luke chapter 7, verse 15 is our key verse to read together. If you got that in your Bibles, would you say amen? We're going to